Hello, I'm Marta, and this is 26th episode about rebuild of my DR350S. This time we will check and adjust valve clearances. First, we demount both valve covers. We are lucky because our engine is taken out from the frame, so we have more space to work. Under the cover you can find an O-ring, and it is good to replace it with a new one. Next, we unscrew the two timing covers. To make it easier to remove, you can punch the wrench with a hammer. We use a socket wrench to rotate the crankshaft counterclockwise to find the cylinder top dead center. You should be able to see T mark at the flywheel. This T marks compression or exhaust stroke, and we have to make sure we are in compression stroke. To do this, we grab both rocker arms and try to move it up and down. During the compression stroke, you should feel some free play. If there is no free play, we need to rotate the crankshaft by one turn. We should also make sure there is a free play at the compression shaft. From the service manual, we need clearance valves for the intake and exhaust valves. First, I checked the exhaust valves using a 0.15mm tin plate. As you can see, there must be more space than recommended 0.13mm at the first valve. So the next step is loosening the valve adjuster locking nuts. This kind of wrench comes in handy to turn the valve adjusters. To set exhaust valve's clearance, I use now a 0.1mm tin plate and insert it under valve adjuster. Next, I screw in the adjuster and move the plate at the same time until the plate will start to get blocked. Then we remove the plate and screw in the locking nut to block the adjuster. Now we make a little test with a 0.08mm tin plate to check if everything is okay. Next we use torque wrench and tighten the nut with 9Nm torque. We repeat this process for the second exhaust valve. When the exhaust valves are ready, we check both once again with the 0.8mm and 0.13mm tin plates. So after this, we are 100% sure this side is ready. Next test is using a 0.13 tin plate, and this time there is not enough space to slide it in. So now we switch to the intake valves. The only change is that we are using plates with different thickness, as we have to set different valve clearances. When all valves are ready, we need to put back the valve covers. As you can see, old O-ring is flat and damaged, so we need to replace it to prevent oil leaking. Before mounting covers, we loop O-rings a little with oil. The last step is screwing back timing covers. We tighten TDC plug with 22 Nm torque. Before screwing back crankcase bolt, we replace O-ring. It should be tightened with 9 to 13 Nm torque, but we were unable to measure it. Good job! Now your engine is ready for a ride! Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed, leave a like and stay tuned for the next videos documenting DR rebuilding!